Hello and greetings from Iceland, but I'm again in the situation where I have to change my plans due to earthquakes and action while I'm constructing a video. But I was working all day on a video about Grindavík with a bunch of new footage, but this new earthquake swarm on the westernmost part of the Reykjanes Peninsula has been interrupting me from time to time today. So I decided to show off my full Grindavík video tomorrow, Saturday, leaving the situation today out of it to make things simpler, and use the chance now to show you around since I was at this new earthquake location just last weekend, and I needed also a chance to show you around there. So let's move above this hot spring that we call Gunnuhver, and this is one of the strongest earthquake swarm on the peninsula for a while, or 4 earthquakes above magnitude 3 just this afternoon, the last one just 15 minutes ago, and they are at 4 to 6 kilometers depth. And the location is offshore but very close to the coast though, and I have spoken about this location before, so I'm linking to that video as well, but here it is, the westernmost part of the peninsula, and let's move a bit closer. There was an eruption here during the 13th century that started offshore, and this rock is a part of an eroded crater since then, and the other remains can be seen on the coast, so this location is no surprise as such. And moving closer, it looks more like this, but this is rough land, and as we move up again and turn north, we see the remains of a row of craters, but the eruption took place both on the seabed and on this fissure that's 4 kilometers long. There is a geothermal power plant nearby, and beside the craters we have this fish farm that uses some of the wastewater from the power plant to maintain the best possible conditions for the fish, so they use the wastewater to heat up the freshwater, because it's a whole lot of energy that else would go to waste. And further out there, we have the Rift Valley I spoke about in a recent video, or where we had some unusual earthquakes last week. So even though we are not seeing any dramatic events now, when we look at the overall situation, things are looking more and more as before the eruption last year, or seismic activity popping up all around the peninsula, making it impossible to guess what's next. And all the land around here is either burnt or broken up by faults and fissure swarms, but on such places, energy is often to be found, but this is not the Blue Lagoon. This is just wastewater from the power plant. The famous Blue Lagoon is by another geothermal power plant nearby, or just by Grindavík that you can see here. And my Grindavík video should be online tomorrow, stuffed with the new footage and information about the overall status on the peninsula. But the earthquakes around here might just fade out, and they are most likely a part of a bigger chain of events, and it's my job to bring you closer at any given time, and this is the landscape around today's events. But don't worry, I have also some of the sweeter sides of Iceland coming up soon, and I'm pretty sure that you will find my Grindavík video interesting as well. It's a nice town, but like here, there are many earthquakes around there now, and things could look better for them, indeed. And as usual, I'm leaving links to some of the many options you have to see the earthquakes online. And if you are new to my channel, please consider to click the subscribe button and the like button for what you like. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.